How many words can you type in a minute? Well, in today's video, we're gonna need you to truly understand the amount of words you can comfortably type per minute. And we're going to give you the ingredients and methods necessary to take your touch typing speed to the next level. But first, head over to the first link in the description below to take a quick typing test. Then come back when you've got your score. Actually, I'll do the test as well. Then we can compare scores. Hi Digmates, I'm Dominique. So how'd you do? 30 words per minute? 50? 80? 100? 100 million?
$100 billion!
Are those scores even very good? You'll find out how your score compares against the rest of the tech world, including me, very shortly. But first, were you touch typing? You know, using all of your fingers on the correct keys without looking at the keyboard? Because I can guarantee you that if you weren't, then you're probably slowing down your typing potential by around 25% minimum. Even though this video specifically focuses on using a split keyboard, the majority of the rules apply to fixed normie keyboards too. So let's first dive in by asking some necessary questions that might affect your starting point. Does size matter? Take a look at your hands. Along with your keyboard, these are your typing tools. It's important to know that while finger lengths and hand sizes may have some small impacts on typing speed and accuracy, true touch typing skill and speed ultimately rely on other factors such as keyboard familiarity, finger dexterity, good ergonomics, adaptability, and your individual variability. Next, what kind of typist are you? There are almost an infinite amount of ways to type on a keyboard outside of touch typing. But we're going to mention the most common three, starting with touch typing, which refers to typing without relying on sight to locate the keys. Touch typists rely on muscle memory to know the key placements on the keyboard. This technique enables the use of both hands and all 10 fingers to work most efficiently. Then you have the most common hunt and peck, two-finger typing. Two-finger typists are generally those who were introduced to keyboards without any form of training. They did what was natural and used their two index fingers to locate and hit every key, like probably your parents or grandparents. And over time, it became the standard and most comfortable way to type. Finally, you have the gamer style of typing. Gamer typists, like many of us, were first introduced to keyboards through gaming. For example, when Half-Life came out, that was the first time when we started using computers. As a result, gamers would commonly use 3 to 4 fingers on their left hand and 1 or 3 fingers on their right. And more often than not, they would shift their hand position one unit to the left, since they're used to the WASD position. Of all three mentioned, touch typing is clearly the most effective. But if one of the others works for you, why even bother switching to touch typing? After all, in the immortal words of John Anderson,
if it ain't broke, don't fix it.
You know, your typing style might not be broken, but the same can be said about an old beat-up car. Sure, it'll get you from A to B, but the journey might be slightly uncomfortable. Let's look at it like this. The average two-finger or gamer-style typist can manage between 25 and 30 words per minute. The average touch typist, 40 and 50 words per minute. Although the difference of 20 words per minute may not seem like much, over the course of an hour, that's an extra 1,200 words or 100 pages of additional text that you could type in a week. By speeding up your touch typing, you'll have the ability to develop and put down your thoughts faster. Just think of how much more productive you can be when you use all 10 fingers. Okay, before we jump into the basics of touch typing, let's talk about your typing speed from the test you took earlier. How do you score against the rest of the tech world? The average typing speed of professional gamers, coders, and typists is between 40 and 70 words per minute. So you probably fall close to that range. Now, the basics. Before you even lay your fingers on the keyboard, it's important to understand the perfect typing posture. Ensure your desk is at the right height and your elbows are bent at a 90-degree angle. Be sure to sit upright with your feet flat on the floor. Position your keyboard directly in front of you, allowing your hands to rest comfortably on each half. And the top of your monitor screen should be aligned with your gaze when sitting upright. When comfortable, lay your hands on the beautiful home row, which is the central reference point. Your index fingers should rest on the F and J keys. They're the ones with the little bumps. Your middle fingers on the D and K keys, the ring finger on the S and L, and the pinkies on the A and semicolon keys. Now we're ready to move on to the next step. The keyboard scheme displays the areas or sections that are assigned to each finger. Each finger has its own zone of operation. But what about these bad boys?
Don't be afraid. Your thumb is the most important finger around.
Well, funnily enough, your strongest fingers are only responsible for one giant key, the space bar. What a weird system, right? Your weakest fingers, the pinkies, have the most work, while your strongest fingers, the thumbs, have the least. This is where our Dygma keyboards throw out the old and bring in the new. Stick around to find out how we can give your thumbs the true amount of work they deserve. Now with the keyboard scheme in sight, let's talk about the drills that we can do. Start by typing something simple you type every day, like your name or your email address, or a common sentence like, I hope your coffee is warmer than your wife's cold heart. Now try that again without looking at the keyboard. Even if that means slowing down and focusing on touching the right keys, do not look at the keyboard. And if you ever get lost, find your way back to the home row by finding the little bumps and start again. Where is the home row? I got lost. Where is the F and J keys?
That's your home! Are you too good for your home?
Now try typing a sentence that includes every letter in the alphabet. Pack my box with 5 dozen liquor jugs. The key here is repetition. Train each finger to nail each key and constantly build that muscle memory. You don't need much, just 10 to 15 minutes a day of touch typing drills can go a long way. One of our favorite sites for touch typing drills is typingstudy.com. Each lesson is broken down into a variety of exercises. You can even finish each lesson with a quick game for extra credit. What else can you expect? Well, aside from an increase in your typing speed, you may experience a little bit of pain. Not only in the frustration of making an uncountable amount of typos, but physical pain.
I am the pain.
Think about it like this. Those poor pinkies have never really had to do any work. I mean, aside from an occasional pinky promise, what do your pinkies do independently? Their workload has just increased by...
It's over 9,000!
What 9,000?
Aches and pains are to be expected in your pinkies, your wrists, and maybe even your thumbs. If you feel you need a day off your touch typing practice to let these areas recover a little, by all means take it. Let's take this up a notch and go to the next level. With programmable keyboards such as the Dygma Defy or the Raise 2, relocating your keys becomes the necessary next step in both increasing your touch typing speed as well as your workflow entirely. We mentioned earlier that despite your thumbs being the most powerful of all your fingers, they really only have to hit one big key in a traditional keyboard. Sure, they have to hit it after every single word, but they can definitely take some of the pressure off those pinkies, right? On the Dygma Defy and the Raise 2, we've introduced a thumb cluster. By remapping those out-of-reach, frequently used keys, such as your backspace, your enter, and shift, you can put them in a spot where your thumbs can easily reach them. With such a simple switch in place, you'll be shocked at how much you can boost your touch typing game. Now that you've remapped your frequently used keys to the thumb cluster, you're ready to take things a little bit further on an ergonomic level. It's time for us to split. Think about it this way. Your hands just aren't supposed to be that close to each other, especially for long hours a day. To avoid a plethora of potential aches, pains, and injuries, you want to be seated and working in a posture that keeps everything as neutral as possible. Your hands should be typing shoulder width apart in a position that allows a comfortable, open-chested posture, and so that your cat can sleep comfortably in the middle while you work. Which is exactly why we developed a split keyboard in the first place. Yep, so that your furry little friends can be with you on those long hours you spend on your computer. Like with every new change in life, it's best to start small. Start by separating your split keyboard by a few millimeters every week. Allow your hands to become accustomed to typing with it split. Over time, increase that split further and further until you look like you're ready to hug Mary Samsonite at the airport. Shoulder width would do just fine. And boom, ergonomic nirvana. But before we end, we do have some final tips. The switches you use can greatly affect your touch typing. If you find that your typing accuracy is low, it might be down to the sensitivity of your switches. For example, Hail Speed Silver, although great for those with excellent typing accuracy, might actually be a bad choice for those who tend to misclick other keys as they type. For this, I recommend getting switches with a higher operating force, or even tactile or clicky ones. Feeling and hearing that additional feedback can really help, and can also make you feel feel like you're doing something meaningful in life. Last is the keycaps. Yes, the keycaps do play a vital role in your touch typing speed. For example, for me, I love my metal keycaps and I use them every day. But for doing this typing test, for example, I noticed that I was 10 words per minute slower with these keycaps than when I was using the plastic ones. I think the heavy weight of the keycaps just made me type a little bit slower. But this might be helpful to other people. Also, low profile or even flat keycaps might help you type faster since there is more surface area so your fingers don't need to travel that far. Oh, and speaking of typing fast, here are my results. It's not 100. The key here is repetition, repetition, and repetition. It might be 100 if I practice more.